The motorcycle. It has been said that four wheels will move your body, but two wheels move the soul. So what we're going to talk about today, we're going to talk about the two-wheel motorcycle, the dangers involved, and also we'll talk about your soul at the same time. Four wheels move the body, but two wheels will move your soul. You guys haven't ridden a motorcycle. It is a lot of fun. But there are some dangers involved, obviously. And I received an email yesterday of a motorcycle rider that had a fatality. There was a video of a person made a video of their friend that had a fatal motorcycle accident. So I have not done any videos really talking about this topic about motorcycle fatalities, but that video moved me because it is part of motorcycle riding. Chances of you having a fatality in a motorcycle accident are obviously higher than in a four-wheel vehicle like a car. So let's talk about some serious stuff. And first I want to tell you guys a little disclaimer before I start. I will be honest with you, tell you I am a Christian. So the things that I talk about are more from a Christian perspective, what I think about it. I was going to say, I'm not trying to change your views on anything, but that would be dishonest. I would love for you to be a Christian. Of course, I'm not going to get, you know, all upset when someone doesn't become a Christian. But I'm going to tell you about the dangers of motorcycle riding. And someone asked me a really good question. They said, Shock, and I know this is going to offend some of my motorcycle friends out there, and please don't be offended. It's not targeted towards you. It was targeted towards me, but it was my opinion. And so I am entitled to my opinion. You know what they say about opinions. Everyone's got one. So they said, Shock, would you ride your motorcycle if you were not a Christian? For example, like if you were an atheist or something like that. My answer is two words, hell no. I would not go ahead and ride a motorcycle if I didn't have my eternity shored up. Now, there's a lot of atheist motorcycle riders, especially out here in Southern California where I'm riding now. But I don't know how they do it. You guys saw the video the other day. I got a flat tire going about 65, 70 on the freeway. And it is the closest thing to death that you will come to. And you are one breath away from death on a motorcycle, especially on the mean, unforgiving freeways of the Inland Empire like I'm on now. You're always one breath away from death. So let's talk about some of the dangers. And for those of you thinking of getting a motorcycle, the first thing that I would tell you, I don't want to be a party pooper, but this is my opinion. I will always be honest with you guys. As you know, even if you disagree with me or I disagree with you, at least you know where I'm coming from. Would I get a motorcycle if I forgot to strap my helmet here? I mean, I strapped it, but I didn't snap it. Would I get a motorcycle? I'm just going to put it underneath my chin. If I was an atheist? Hell no. No, under no circumstances would I get one. I've had it where people have almost... right here, right at this freeway, almost at the exact same moment, there was an old man, sweet old man over here. He almost killed me. He pulled right in over next to me. That video is called Sweet Old Man Almost Kills Me. Or a sweet old man tries to kill me. I've had people come at me head on. And so the dangers are so immense and so tremendous on a motorcycle, even if you're a Christian. But I do not, for the life of me, and I please don't be offended, I wouldn't say if I didn't love you guys and gals out there on motorcycles, I do not for the life of me know how someone could enjoy their ride not knowing that they have their eternity in order. I personally wouldn't get a motorcycle. I wouldn't. I gotta tell you something, there are some atheist motorcycle, look at, so he's a Christian. There are some atheist motorcycle riders and they'll email me and I got no problem with them teasing me and stuff. The Lord knows I tease them. And I'm thick skinned, us bikers, you know, we could talk about hot topics and totally disagree with each other and then we'll go ride together. It's just conversation. No one gets their widow feelings hurt. Bikers are thick skinned like that. So I had this one atheist biker, he's very well known on YouTube, and he emails, well actually no, he put it in the comment section of one of my videos. And he's like, well shock, if you're a Christian, why are you wearing a helmet? And shock, if you're a Christian, why are you wearing all your gear then, you know? Well, I don't like to really put down my fellow biker. I don't like to do that, you know, I want to get along with them and stuff. So I didn't say what I wanted to say. I'm like, yeah, yeah, ha ha, hee hee. But since I'm doing this video anonymously, to me, it's the complete opposite. How could someone ride a motorcycle? Look at this bird right here flying along. It almost hit that Suburban with. To me, it is more dangerous to ride a motorcycle with, if you're leathered up and you have all the safety gear and everything, and you're a non-believer, you're an atheist. To me, that is so much more dangerous than riding some, like someone like me. Let's say I was in shorts right now and no helmet and no gloves and just like shorts and flip-flops like sandals. But you're an atheist and you're all geared up and you're all like helmet and stuff. I would rather be in my position. I would rather be the Christian riding in flip-flops and shorts than the atheist who's all geared up and, you know, like they're all safe. And well, yeah, you are protecting your flesh, but you ain't protecting your soul. The start of this video, I said, four wheels moves the body, but two wheels moves the soul. And follow along with me. If there is an eternity, obviously that's a lot longer than this life. Imagine you and I are on the beach and you pick up one little tiny infinitesimal grain of sand, one little grain, and you're holding that in your hand. That grain of sand represents the time you have and I have on this planet. But eternity represents all the other grains of sand for miles and miles. I mean, and even more so than those. Why am I going to go ahead and focus and put my priority on the one little grain of sand, which is of less value to me than eternity? So if you're thinking of riding a motorcycle, your chances of a fatality are a lot higher. Is it fun? Heck yeah, it's a blast. Are the dangers worth it? I believe it is if you're a Christian. I know there's tons of motorcycle riders out there that are not Christians and you'll disagree with me. That's okay. I respect you to have your beliefs. I don't agree with your beliefs, but I have tolerance for you to have your beliefs, and I hope you would have tolerance for mine. But know this, my concern is not for that little one grain of sand. My concern is for our eternity. If you're a Christian, you're a believer, you want to be a motorcycle rider, hey, knock yourself out. You will have a blast. However, if you that are watching this video are thinking of buying a motorcycle and you're a non-believer, I wouldn't do it myself. The risks are so high, and especially if you don't have your house in order, your eternity shored up. The risks are so high that it would not be worth the rewards. God bless you guys. This is Shock, and have a great week.